myself. No.
Life-changingly crucial moment in the lives of two people and their families about whom you care very much. We are delighted you are here. We are gathered here to join Walter and Casey in marriage, to witness and to celebrate that out of all the world they have found each other and wish to share together the joys and the hardships of this human adventure we call life. It is fitting that you, their families, and friends should be present, witnessing their covenant with each other, for it is from you that they have derived the love, the respect, the hope, and the understanding that they bring to their marriage. A marriage is a time for families and friends to come together, but there are those who cannot be with us today. We remember those who have passed from us, those who are unable to travel, those who are too far away to be with us, and all others who would join us in spirit at the union of Walter and Casey. Especially we remember Arthur, Genevieve, Llewellyn, Kathy, Roger, and Mickey. And John. We'll have the first reading.
Respect and remind yourselves often of what brought you together. Give the highest priority to the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your connection deserves. When frustration, difficulty, and fear assail your relationship, as they threaten all relationships at one time or another, remember to focus on what is right between you, not only the part which seems wrong. In this way, you can ride out the storms when clouds hide the face of the sun in your lives, remembering that even if you lose sight of it for a moment, the sun is still there. And each of you takes responsibility for the quality of your life together, and it will be marked by abundance and delight.
I also chose a reading. Many years ago now, the writer Anne Lindbergh made a personal journey, personal retreat to one of the islands off the New England coast, not far from here, not in Narragansett Bay, but one of the islands, the Elizabeth Islands off New Bedford. And she went there to pursue her thoughts and feelings about herself, about life in general, about relationships, about family, about responsibility, about love. The outcome of this personal odyssey was the little treasure of a book called Gift from the Sea. She wrote, "When you love someone, you do not love them all the time in exactly the same way from moment to moment. It is an impossibility. It is even a lie to pretend to. And yet this is exactly what most of us demand. We have so little faith in the ebb and flow of life, of love, of relationships. We leap at the flow of the tide and resist in terror its ebb. We are afraid it will never return. We insist on permanency, on duration, on continuity, when the only continuity possible in life, as in love, is in growth, in fluidity, in freedom, in the sense that dancers are free, barely touching as they pass, but are partners in the same pattern. The only real security is not in owning or possessing, not in demanding or expecting, not in hoping even. Security in a relationship lies neither in looking back to what it was in nostalgia, nor forward to what it might be in anticipation or in dread, but living in the present relationship and accepting it as it is now. For relationships must be like islands. One must accept them for what they are here and now within their limits, islands surrounded and interrupted by the sea, and continually visited and abandoned by the tides. One must accept the security of the winged life, of the ebb and the flow, of intermittency. No matter how well two people know each other, or for how long, or under what circumstances, when they come before their families and friends and make the public commitment to each other that we recognize as a wedding, it changes that relationship. It changes it in ways which are important and varied. It changes it in ways that are legal, that are emotional, that are personal, that are also very public. We have the idea from popular music, from popular writing of all sorts, from poetry of the ages, that life is supposed to be perfect all the time. We really know that it isn't, but we think it should be. And we try and make it that way as much as we can. And that's fine, but we don't always know exactly how to do that. Partly, it is by accepting and being ready for whatever comes. I mean, it might be nice if we could get out our calendars, or I guess our Palm Pilots today, and say, well, I see I have a few minutes of free time next Wednesday afternoon. I guess I will create for myself a moment of joy and wonder and love and excitement. But it doesn't happen that way. For some, the moment of awe or inspiration may come as we are driving down a road that we're not familiar with, and the vista of Narragansett Bay or the White Mountains or the prairies or whatever it is we are crossing opens up before us, and we say it literally takes our breath away. Or it may be, if we're lucky, when the big brown truck pulls up in front of the house, the UPS guy gets out, puts a box on the front steps, we go out there, it's directed to us, we open it, it's the thing we ordered, all the parts seem to be in there, and we put it all together and everything works. And we think, wow. But it doesn't always happen that way. Or it may be at a gathering like this, when across the room we see someone that we haven't seen for a long, long time, and we're so delighted to see them, and we make our way across, and they're just as delighted to see us, and we can't describe how that feels. It's so wonderful. The challenge is to be prepared for what life offers, and for whatever it is that it offers, to learn and to strive to make the most of it, to build together a life of joy, of wonder, of strength for the difficult times, of insight and wisdom to see the opportunities, a life of hope, excitement, joy, love. Most of all, of love. And not just between the two of you, but also reaching out to all whom your lives will touch. That is our hope. That is our prayer. The marriage of two people is an honorable estate, not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, soberly, and in all sincerity. To endure, the marriage of two people must ever be a renewed choice, a consecration of each to the other, and of both to the wider community of which their lives are a part. As two separate beings, you will find the deeper meaning and richness of human life through the sharing of it with each other. From joys and sorrows shared, you will grow in love and loyalty. From any pain given and forgiven, you will grow in mutual understanding. What we here celebrate, the church sanctifies and the state makes legal, you alone together must make real. Casey and Walls, is it with this sacred purpose, and is it freely and without reservation, that you have come here to give yourselves to each other in marriage? And is it with the blessings and good wishes of your families and friends that you're embarking on this new venture?
It is. Yes. Yes.
Walter, do you take Casey to be your wife, in her strength and sensitivity, her courage and honesty, and do you pledge to be aware of her needs, to respect her individuality and uniqueness, to share in love given and received? Casey, do you take Walter to be your husband, in his strength and sensitivity, his courage and honesty? And do you pledge to be aware of his needs, to respect his individuality and uniqueness, to share in love given and received? Through laughter and tears, through success and failure, through conflict and tranquility, through health and illness, I want to take you, Casey, as my wife and equal. Through laughter and tears.
Through laughter and tears.
Through success and failure.
Through success and failure.
Through conflict and tranquility.
Through conflict and tranquility.
Through health and illness.
Through health and illness.
I can
see.
Take you, Walter.
Take you, Walter.
As my husband and equal.
As my husband and equal.
The circle is the symbol of the sun and the earth and the universe. It is a symbol of perfection, of peace, of holiness. In these rings, it is the symbol of unity, the unity at which your two lives are now joined as an unbroken circle, in which wherever you go, you will strive always to return to one another in your shared life. May this ring ever serve as a reminder of your pledge. Keep the circle whole. This ring serve as a reminder of your intention to share a common life. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
To wear upon your hand.
To wear upon your hand.
As a symbol of our unity.
As a symbol of our unity.
I would ask the mothers to come forward and each light one of the two side candles. It's a symbol of hope and festivity, of wisdom and of a goal. It is the symbol of hospitality and of home. In the unity candle, it is all of these things, and also a symbol of the way in which Walter and Casey are taking the inheritance of love and hope they have received from their respective families, and now begin the creation of a new family together. This new family includes all generations, past, present, and future, in their respective families. But it is centered and grounded in the relationship made formal and public here today. Theirs is thus a courageous new light in a world so fraught with darkness. Walter and Casey. Can be defined in its living entity by neither law nor custom. What you see in each other, what you feel for each other, what you bring to each other today will not be what you see or feel or bring tomorrow. The journey upon which you embark through changing ways and shifting skies will offer ever new and richer experiences, a deeper and more significant relationship. Walter and Casey, because of the hopes you have voiced, the pledges you have made here today, you have pronounced yourselves husband and wife. But as the winds shift, as the tides advance and recede, as the stars and planets move in their courses and your lives unfold, you must refresh these hopes and renew these pledges and constantly choose each other anew.
Now there will be no loneliness, for each of you will be companion to the other. Now you are two persons, but there is only one life before you. May beauty surround you, both in the journey ahead and through all the years. May happiness be your companion, and your days together be good and long upon the earth.
Let us pray. O Lord, may these two loving people, Casey and Walter, find happiness in their union. May they live faithfully together, performing the covenant now between them made. May they ever remain in sympathy and understanding, and may their years be rich in the joys of living and loving. Amen.
The grandmother of the balloon, please welcome Miss Ruth Conklin. Next, we have our parents of the bride. Please welcome our mother of the bride, Miss Susan Wallace, escorted by our father of the groom, Miss Jack Wallace.
He asked him how old Lori was. misty breeze of my waterfall. Some people say daydreaming's for all the, huh, lazy-minded fools with nothing else to do. So let them laugh at me. So just as long as I have you, you see me through and nothing to lose. Long as I have you, waterfall, don't ever change your ways. Follow with me for a million days. Oh, my waterfall. Here's the second half. I've known Walter for a long time. He used to be my boss over at Lavin's Marina, and... I used to have to fetch him beers all the time, and it was really rough. But when no one was looking, he was a really nice guy. He used to give me one or two. We've had some good times hanging out over on the boat and inside of the van and whatnot. We've done all kinds of cool things, and I'm just really glad that he met Casey. They're a great couple. I'm really proud of them. I'm so happy that they're together, and God bless you. And I hope you all have a good time here tonight, and let's party.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated and enjoy your meal. Alright, that works. So, who's the winning table, this side or this side?
How sweet it is to be loved.
Ladies. sing it, plus we miss you. We always miss you.
So good! So good! I got you! So good! So good! I got you! So good! So good! I got you!
Pizza. Now, Deb, what kind of pizza are we waiting for? Now, I never even heard of an eggplant pizza. I never knew they made such a thing.
Where's the rest of the game? Once they leave, they never return.
Yeah, well, it's 1:41.
Shit, many kids.
And it's,
tell you, I'm ready to go to bed myself.
You know what? I gotta buy you a case of Geritol.
What are they doing?
Seven.
They're trailing me here.
Look at, not like just fits me. Seven.
What do you want to do? You want to make a call to try to
the wedding. They had just gotten them.
Kenny's got sunglasses on because his eyes are so red he can't see. And Tommy's over there, bright and chipper.
I love him.
Yep.
Everybody's
first time I ever saw you act up last night.
Here's famous Jack Wallace.
We're having mimosas, Casey and Walter.
What were you going to pay? What were they there?
Mimosas. First thing in the morning.
We're celebrating.
You're not on
thinking
the beach
about
yet.
You guys on the
we were in 607.
Getting the tan.
So they were 603.
We're going out to 20 degree weather.
Hey, you guys want to get in bed? I'll take some. Hey, that's all we need. Take a picture.
I know. She's just like Jackie. It's like get away when he had that big huge camera.
Roberto.
Yeah, like a big movie.
Roberto, model your sweater. Model that beautiful sweater. Did Roberta look beautiful last night or what?
Thank you very much.
Oh my God. Were there any eligible men there? There weren't.
No, there weren't.
What a waste. I'm telling you, you could have picked up every man in that place.
Really?
Oh my God.
Thank you.
That was a beautiful outfit.
Thank you. Right, and those red toenails.
She's
got red toenails.
Barbara, I'm going to take my pants down. Ready?
No.
Sorry, Casey.
Hey, there's a moon over my head.
What do you think? You're a goddamn flower?
Video.
That must have been the eclipse.
You know, you were right there. Though.
That was the eclipse.
I think we're the only people that could have her go to a wedding last for a whole week.
Deb, don't you say anything.
All right, come on. Just say goodbye. I hope you carry your bag. Plus, we're with the little devil niece.
You're going to get in trouble.
What does she need, Joan? I mean, Tina. What does she need?
She's got your phone.
That's what
you need
to do. And we also have pretzels and mustard. In case you get hungry. Todd, do you like it hot?
I already had a bottle of water.
Of course.
That's a loaded question.
Yeah.
I'm behaving.
Don't we all?
What's that?
No, you do like it spicy? That's horseradish.
Hot and spicy.
Horseradish?
I think some hot sauce.
Heidi.
That's
it.
From Heidi.
That's the way he likes his Bloody Mary and the way he likes his woman. Yeah. Hot and spicy.
Horseradish is the best. Finest.
Justin. Excellent job.
It's spicy. It's good.
Yeah?
What the thing here?
Do you want,
performance yesterday. Tuxedo.
Todd, do you want a piece of celery?
Sure.
Oh. This guy screwed up. You didn't pull the thing down right.
What are you talking about? I thought I pulled that down right.
I grabbed you by the shirt.
Yeah.
You were going with me at one point.
I know, but I mean, at one point, if we ever went there, we never would have found our way back.
Yeah,
I would have. I wasn't that bad.
I was bad.
Maybe about five drinks. That's nothing.
Then 25 more when we got there. You'd know what that would be up there.
They don't close it, too.
Five drinks more.
Where is Patrick's now?
Right up Smith Street. It's a little hole in the wall. You know the weenie joint? Right before that on the right.
Right on Smith Hill, Chalkstone and...
Yeah, right before that on the right.
All right.
Oh, he's fucking nuts. Can you tell he's sexually deprived? He's like a fucking dog and he... I know!
We got her like Heidi from the Uncle Heidi.
Grandfather! Okay, now don't mess this up again. Get out! You jerk, asshole. Here you go. Here you go, muffle him up! Disgusting.
This is pornographic.
I know, I tell you what.
I tell you,
Johnny Wad's got nothing in this room.
Johnny Wad. I haven't heard that name in a long time.
Bing, bang, boom.
And Linda Lovelace.
Yeah.
Yeah, with the Lovelies.
Tommy! Get out of here! You're crazy! You're crazy! He's fucking...
I put a limit on things. Yeah.
I put a limit on things. Next time, let me know ahead of time so I can open my mouth. Oh. Oh, man. Get that thing off.
The IRS is...
Oh, that's it.
Oh, my God.
He loves it. Oh, my God. Want to see my pimples?
Okay. Is this
wet? No, it's
aggressive.
You don't have it.
I do it. I have it right here. It's in here.
Yes,
I do.
Where is
I was going to take some pictures.
Hi, Jack.
All right, Leslie, you're in a boss's seat.
How come she gets to see? I'm not very far. This is Lisa's husband, Tom.
Oh, hi.
This is Peggy.
How do I know you?
She plays tennis. I used to play tennis with Lisa. A long time ago when she played on Saturdays, but now she's too much better than me.
Hi, Jack.
Hi, Roberta. How you
very
doing?
Very nice of you to invite me tonight.
Oh, I'm glad you came.
I love you.
Ready? Excuse me.
Jack, I gotta clear out.
With the high hole silver. That's it. Half price.
It's a Christmas special.
Because we aim to please. It's the best present you can get.
Mrs. Gilmore's using it at the moment.
Hey, wait a minute.
Actually, I was a model for this.
Wait a minute. If she's using it, she broke it last year.
She broke it.
I was one of the initial models for this.
That's why we had to modify it. We had to add stainless steel nuts. She broke through those steel nuts like Grant took Richmond. Hey.
That's a good end to spray. Hey!
Happy, merry. Yeah, happy, merry.
Put that thing away. Come on.
Don't shove it
where the sun don't shine.
Oh, I tell you, will you?
Hey,
Mr. Smith.
Hello.
Of course. That's why I brought it. I want to take some pictures.
What's going on out here, Dad? Wait for the bathroom?
Oh, look at it. I'm trying to focus on this picture over there.
Oh, these guys, you ever play that game? Hey, I got some new dots here, too.
Workspace area.
That's so funny.
Hey, put on the computer. That's it. See you later.
Yeah. Yeah, up with Roger, actually.
I know.
My wife wanted to do Cuddles and Bubbles, but she won't go with a group, so never mind. It's all.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Hey, LeFleur. Donald. Bob. Merry Christmas. Ho, ho, ho.
Yeah, I saw that. That was more than just a
You're a single lady. Hey, let me get my nuclear nipple stuff.
Get down.
Let me go get my nuclear nipple.
Let me see. Tommy's great.
Oh, Tommy, it's not you. It's the girls.
I swear to God.
I know it. I just saw it with that. They can't resist you. I know.
Hey, Camille, how you doing?
Hi, Jack.
Yeah, I don't know if that's fine. I know. Listen. Having my baby.
Hey, Tom, let me give you my jar of nuclear nipples.
Get out of here.
Raymond, I know what you need.
I don't get nipples.
nipples aren't there, Pat.
Nuclear nipples.
Things
have been redone last week.
Good thing I got a good sense of humor. That's all I can say. Right, Jackie?
Right, right, right.
Good thing.
That's it.
You know why? Because I do it because I'm at Riverside.
That's it. You're at Riverside, babe.
Riverside.
Riverside. Hey, Tommy.
There you go, now there's a picture.
Is it too bad?
I know, hey.
Hey.
Wow.
Uncle and nephew.
That's it.
Yeah, that's it.
That's it.
Got a wide angle lens.
Richie, turn around. Back.
Oh, boy. Hey, Deb, hey, how you doing, Debbie?
Yeah. Oh, Jesus, it's going to be a tough one.
I always take pictures.
Oh, my God, no, I'm not going to look like
this. Nah, you can just call me Jack. You don't have to call me God.
Oh, Anime's hiding.
Anime, you look like you need more Coke?
Uh-oh.
You need more Coke?
I need more Coke, Jack.
All right. You know what?
You cannot leave until this whole can is gone.
I don't have a problem with that. You know why? Because I love it.
That is fucking bad.
I love it. I love it. I love it. You picked one of my most favorite stuff.
Horseradish.
Horseradish. Oh, it's my favorite. It's my favorite. Horseradish. I can't. This is a punishment? This is a punishment? It's not for nothing. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Jenny. The day after. It's the day after.
Oh, yeah, it is.
The day after.
The day after. And I've been at it, and it's not getting any easier. I'm getting too old.
Oh, it keeps you busy.
And what is this here?
Oh, that's extra. This is all the basic food groups.
What's the matter, Jack? Couldn't you get rid of this? Look at this can of tuna fish.
Yeah, isn't that good?
He bought this about 4 years ago, and he's been trying to pass it off on people.
That's going to be your Christmas present.
But no one seems to be, and I can't find when it expires.
It doesn't. It lasts forever.
And no, it doesn't. It's got to expire sometime. What is it, Jack?
What?
Mom wants
to know if she can take the
photo album from the
wedding.
Yeah.
Yeah.
His mother made.
Okay, this is Casey's 25th birthday, the day after the 25th birthday.
Well, you told me.
It's a late day after because she was sick on her birthday. Casey, how does it feel to be a quarter of a century?
So far, so good.
All right, don't bother.
You know what, Casey?
I can't
if you
ask him anything.
If you double that speed, double that age, what will it be?
I know.
I don't even want to talk about it.
Now let's look at Casey's cake. She's got a snowman. It's a snowman. And she's got a case. Now, let me see. It says, Happy Birthday, Casey, 25. Well, we could just reverse it.
Yeah. And be old. Like your
grandmother. I know.
Okay. Jackie eating Chinese food. There's Kenny covering his face.
You're eating my cake with a straw.
Yeah.
You want some masks?
On the quarantine.
There's the mother.
Masks.
The mother of all mothers.
You doing better, kid?
Okay.
Okay. nice.
Oh. That could be a 2-hour shot.
Oh, that's a nice car. Thank you. Stuff.
I picked it out. Choose an enjoyable spot. I picked it out.
Two cards?
Oh. Isn't it coming?
No, it's at the mall.
Oh, boy.
This car just came from out of drop the mall.
And now you gotta go pick
it up. Oh, that's nice.
You're gonna pick him up tonight?
Oh, cute. Oh my goodness. Another little toy. Let me. Like it's mine.
Get out of there.
I know.
Ooh. Where's Walter?
He's sick.
He's good.
He gave it to him.
Does he have the same thing you have?
Yeah,
we're gonna be sick if we stay with her.
Oh my god.
The SpongeBob too.
Ooh. Oh, sexy.
Thank
oh,
you.
Sexy.
I wasn't sure when she was pulling up.
I know. I thought it was going to be a dog.
Oh, these are very nice. These on when I go home.
Oh, wow.
It's a pajama.
Mm.
Oh, I was going to say, it's very soft.
You want a glass of
wine? Oh,
yeah,
I see.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Oh, this is nice.
Oh.
Can you feel it?
Oh, very nice.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Hello.
And you.
Yeah. It's very nice.
If you don't like it, Casey, don't be afraid to just say,
yeah,
I don't like
okay.
this. This stinks.
Listen, when I bought the pajamas, I thought you were sick.
I was thrilled. You were hanging out in your pajamas.
What are you doing? You going to make it too?
Yeah. I just got some stuff.
Everyone want a glass of wine?
I haven't
even been
home
yet.
Yeah,
oh,
I can't wait to put
the
pajamas on.
Holy Ram, your roast is leaking.
What is it?
My what?
Roast is
leaking.
It is.
Stuff
that I forgot a plate. I love that. Hey, now, wait a minute.
Oh,
well,
we got,
but the wind, it has
a
blower.
There's plenty of Budweiser's in the
cooler.
There's Coors Light in there, and there's Bud Light, and there's
Casey, you want a glass of wine, Maya? You want a glass of wine?
No, 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 thanks. Oh, yeah.
Bud and
Coors.
Oh, that's awesome.
That's different.
Ain't enough room in it.
So, what do it? Just keeps making noise.
Oh, that's cool. Thank you so much.
Holy mackerel, what are you getting in
there? Oh, thank you very much, Barbara. That's very nice.
Hey, don't break it.
Happy birthday.
I didn't know what to get you, Casey, and I couldn't figure it out. I was going to get you a nice dress or something, but so I hate to just give you money, but like. Well, yeah, you can get what
that's
you want.
That's okay, I don't hate to receive it.
Money works.
Hey, maybe now you can go get your...
I would have got her a nice teapot, Jack. She would have loved a teapot rather than that.
Yeah,
or she's got a red one.
Oh, thank you.
All right, you ready?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Casey. Happy birthday to you.
Okay, alternate blower. Alternate blower, blow him out. Okay. Good job. Okay.
Because she don't want to blow on the kid.
Hey, Grandpa got Jackie a present.
Did you see
him? All right, there we are. Christmas 2003.
Did they even see him when they were here?
Christmas 2003. Alright, this is just the beginning. I'll take pictures later. Emma. Hey.
I don't want to drop it on
Okay. Here it is. December 25th, the year 2003, the day Thursday. As you can see, it looks like it's Christmas Day. No, I don't think so. Open a window there behind you, Kate.
No. Oh, thank you.
Look at these doors looking up that gravy.
He's getting out the chow.
He figures everything's better, Troy.
You can't. Well, I assume your mother's going to sit there. You can sit next to your mother.
Mom. Yep, just grab a seat. Can I sign?
And then we drink.
Sit right here.
No. Is my mom sitting?
I assume she's going to sit there.
Just grab a seat.
Next to me.
See your mom. Wherever you wish. Okay, get your
plate. Either that or where's, who else we got here? We got, you guys want to sit up there? We're going to sit up here. We got more plates than we have people.
The bottle you left from last year.
Oh, okay. All right.
Oh, yeah.
Are we sure with ourselves?
Well, I don't know what to do here.
Can we start now? You want apple cider, Nick?
All right, who are we missing? We're missing Kenny.
Yeah, Kenny, where are you?
What the heck are you doing? That's not good.
Do you have a bottle opener down here? No, but I'll get one.
Where did it go?
What did you think? That was a bottle opener?
No. Never mind, you don't need it.
It's one on the other side.
That's
how I got so much. I don't really get it, but whatever, man. Exactly, I can't believe you would do that.
Right, we're going to
turn these.
Here.
I don't
want to
open it now.
Here. It's
going to
fly
all over the place.
Why is it
going to
fly?
Take
well, don't you take
no,
the
just
other
open way? It like you're supposed to. It'll be a lot easier.
Yeah, this way.
Nicholas, the other way.
Huh?
The other way. The opener. Usually the opener.
Go like that. Down under the lip. Oh, it's not plugged in, by. It wouldn't reach to the outlet. What are you doing?
Oh, boy, it's not me. It isn't me. I'm just relaxing. Yeah,
try turning the light off now.
Nah, this is good the way it is. I want to be able to see what I'm eating. I don't want to eat in the dark.
It's so bright. Yeah, we can turn right. The light off. Shut it off,
Ken. You're eating in the dark, for Christ's sake.
Oh,
man.
Oh,
Jesus. Now I can't even see my spinach, for Christ's sake.
We have a solid fruit. Well, we're eating like real people.
Yeah.
We're not just going to grab it and maul it.
Come over here. Come sit next to Dad.
All right, come on, everybody sit down. We got to say grace.
Oh, yes, we got to say grace.
Where's my salad?
Grace.
Oh, okay.
You need to sit okay. Down.
Okay. Okay. Jack, are you going to sit down and say grace with
okay. Okay, the first pitcher, we had our plates full. The second pitcher, the plates are empty, our stomachs are full. And the third pitcher will be all on the tote.
Well, can't we go and open our presents?
Oh, you want to go open your presents?
You're always in a rush, Mother.
Well, I mean, you know. I
told you, we're here at 4 in the morning. Don't worry about it.
That's
relax.
All right, but I want to see what's in those boxes.
No work tomorrow.
Mrs. Who? Casey's working. Walter's working. Jack's working.
Joe's working.
Come on, Saturday.
Swim.
Next year, Christmas.
I got to go swim.
Saturday.
At 9 o'clock. What's tomorrow?
Sunday.
When did you go back?
No, Saturday. Skips Friday. Yep.
Yeah, because this is leap year.
Week and tomorrow's half. Friday? I could have sworn today was tomorrow is Saturday.
When we go back. Your trash will be picked up a day later. Don't bite on
Not this Monday.
You get Monday off.
Yeah. Well,
so that's a good vacation.
No, ain't something to get into on Christmas Day.
Hey, Jackie.
You're going to push your bastard stuff, Ma.
Body spray.
What's the matter, Elijah?
Becky, a little Pepto-Bismol. That's probably too much. Whoops.
Oh, it's not from that.
Are you saying you're going to be on blood pressure pills, or Prozac, or Viagra? Oh, Prozac.
Jack, you're going to be okay.
Yeah,
you're going to be okay.
Yeah,
you're going to be okay.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Well, who's the designated?
And it's outside.
Oh. And,
okay, here we are. It's, it's about 5 o'clock, here. And it's...
And now I'm going to work my little finger off.
Mm-hmm. There's Kenny's lamp that he made. It's a birch tree with an African pine...
birch.
African birch, I'm sorry. There's
not
a stump.
African.
There was an African, Riverside birch.
It's just white birch.
White birch from Seekonk and a Riverside tree trunk. And the lampshade came from Ann and Hope. And we got over here. And then there's Debbie.
Merry
She's still
Christmas.
Here. Merry Christmas, 2003. We're just admiring the lamp. It's got a Seekonk birch with a Riverside pine base. With a Ann and Hope top shade.